sound, camera, tape recorder.
This is the Concord F20 reel-to-reel rim drive tape recorder. This particular part of the film is to demonstrate how the machine actually works. When the machine, the little switch here is pressed to the play or section, or the start section actually, because the record button could be pressed in and it would record. This little reel table spins, and if there were tape, was tape in the machine, it would pull the tape across the record playback head. It is now turning the rewind table. It's not a very fast rewind. This machine is called a rim drive tape recorder because it does not have any capstan or flywheel, and the power to the machine, to the reels, is done on the rim of the reel tables, one of which is located here. The other reel table I have removed for illustration purposes. The operation is very simple. There's a little motor here which is controlled by a switch here. When the switch is pressed into the play mode, the motor, which is pressing against the take-up reel table, causes it to turn. There is a speed control here, which is a thumb wheel control that simply increases or lowers the speed. So you can see it's now spinning faster, and now it is spinning slower. The reason for the speed control is to conserve tape because the machine takes very, very small reels. There is a brake system on this machine, which is a little piece of brass which is located underneath the reel tables. When the machine is in the off position, this little piece of brass is swung up and it presses against the rubber on the bottom of the reel table. When the switch is in either the forward or the rewind position, the little piece of brass is pushed down and out of the way so that the table can run freely. There is a record interlock switch here. There is a microphone input jack here. There is a switch jack here, which is part of the microphone system. You simply push a switch on the microphone to turn power on and off to the machine. And there is an earphone jack here for using the machine with an earphone or plugging into an external speaker. There is a single record erase head supported by a pressure pad, which is located here, which I can move back and forth. When the machine is put into the play mode, the pressure pad presses the tape against the head. When the machine is in the stop mode or the rewind mode, the pressure pad is disengaged. When the machine is in the rewind mode, it simply angles this little motor so that it presses against the rewind reel table. There is a battery compartment located, molded to the case, which is permanently wired into the circuit board. So one has to be very careful when working with the machine not to tear any of the wires off the connections. This is the entire circuit board for the machine. It controls the motion of the motor and also the amplification and record playback function. There's a very tiny speaker located here which sends sound out through the bottom of the machine, which is located over there. The speaker is not held in permanently. It has a small little cup that holds it in place. With the speaker removed, we can see the little motor that drives the tape take up and rewind reels. The motor has some springs that located in a cradle, and as the machine switch is moved, the motor moves, which you can't really see because the motion is so tiny. And that's how power is transmitted to the reel take up tables. There is a switch here that when the machine is put into the rewind mode, it reverses the direction of the motor so that it rewinds properly. That's basically the inside of the machine and all there is to it.
Hello. Recorder-Concord.